half a day, now we see Pedro Blas, bantu no anu sejuk, gini ni bonito na song-song gitu tigo, za lansaru jan dadaru tu ambigi finat CHamoru.
Pedro Blas said growing up, he always heard his father speak CHamoru to his grandmother. It was at a young age he wanted to learn his language. He attributes his father for igniting that spark.
He's pretty much like the biggest inspiration for me to even be doing stuff like this because ever since I was little, you know, he would take me down here to the ranch and whether it be like feeding the pigs, pasturing the cow, I've always wanted to follow him. And I knew that I was tied to the culture somehow just because of growing up around stuff like that, you know.
Blas, who currently is a junior at the University of Guam, majoring in CHamoru studies, says it was when he got into the university that he really started to want to learn more.
I took a History of Guam class with Dr. Tori, and man, she just opened my eyes to a lot of stuff in CHamoru history that I didn't know about. And it showed me, you know, like, I think this is where I should be, you know, being called Chad all my life. I should, if since me going to school, I felt like the best thing I could do to keep me going there is to follow my passion, and my passion is to be a CHamoru.
According to Blas, it was when he took elementary CHamoru that everything started to fall into place.
From there, you know, with all the little words my dad threw at me growing up, it kind of helped me out, get me by. And once I learned the structure of the sentences and stuff, like what words go where, then I figured out, you know, I'm pretty good at it now. So that's what got me into writing the music. Song and all.
Along with writing music, Blas picked up the guitar and is self-taught. He says he was inspired by stories of his late grandfather.
My grandpa was in a band and, you know, he would always play music. And I felt like if my grandpa can do it, you know, and my grandpa raised cows and all of that, you know, this should be me. So I picked up a guitar.
As far as writing music, he says the first song he wrote was when his mother passed away when he was in the fourth grade. It was when he got a feel for the writing process, putting pen to paper, and it's something he gravitated towards as he got older.
Throughout the years, as I went through the phases, you know, I wrote songs to make the girls like me and all of that. And, so once I got to UOG and I started learning CHamoru and how sentences are structured, I felt like writing the CHamoru music, even though I couldn't speak it fluently, like on the spot at the time, as long as I'm writing it down, and you know, that was a way to test myself to see if I could do it. You know?
He believes that the culture is not dying and says that FestPack really played a big role in getting people interested and wanting to do their part in preserving and perpetuating the culture.
It's all up to our people, you know, and with all these opportunities to, you know, like this, the Culture Club is a great example of people, you know, it can inspire people to participate in cultivating the culture. But it's just really up to the people, and if they really want to do it in their hearts, then That's how I see it. It's not going to die as long as people have the passion to do it.
As for what the future has in store for Blas?
Hopefully what I can do is give inspiration to, if I become a teacher, to inspire the younger generation to actually want to learn it, whether they're Chamorro or not, you know, because they're on Guam. So just to learn the language, little bits and pieces too, that's fine, you know. And I don't discourage anybody if they don't know how to speak Chamorro, because I myself at one time didn't know how to speak Chamorro.